Roman Anders.
Sum it up, I think that we didn't establish a rushing game early, and a lot of that falls on the offensive line, obviously. And you know, I think that we just kind of put ourselves in a hole that was tough to get out of. And you know, when we had a good field position, when it really counted, I don't think we executed. And we definitely just got to improve on that. You know, I think we definitely have a lot of work to do, and getting ready for New Mexico next week. This game kind of opened our eyes to some of the areas that we need to improve on offensively.
Questions? I don't think you guys gave up the sack tonight. I mean, that is a good something you can hang your hat on against a Boise State defense that has 21 sacks. I mean, is that a fair statement?
Yeah, I mean, that was definitely a focus going into this week. We, you know, put a lot of emphasis, especially me being a tackle, about you know, setting the defensive ends, being prepared for them, being prepared for the different blitzes, and playing with great technique and great effort, and being physical, even in the passing game. And I think that you know, the fact that we didn't get many sacks is a reflection of that.
Is there anything in particular that Boise does to, you know, rank pretty highly in the nation against the run?
I mean, I don't think it's necessarily anything that they do. I think that we just didn't execute like we should have. They have a little bit of line movement, one lateral step, and then they get vertical, which is something that everyone does. But you know, the way that we could have executed better is just with better footwork and you know, just keeping our eyes up and pick up the guys there.
After falling behind 14-0, did you notice something different with your teammates mentally on the sideline? Were they more out of the game, or did it fire them up to try to get back to you?
I honestly think that it fired us up. I mean, we've been down by 14 three times a season, you know, once on BYU and twice with UNLV. So, I mean, it wasn't a position that we were uncomfortable in being in. So we came out fired up, but, like I said, we just didn't execute, and back from it, so put ourselves in a hole. And I mean, it's tough to keep making those 14 point comebacks, so it just comes down to got to execute earlier on in the end of the game.
Anything else for Roman? Okay,
it wasn't a good night for the Aggies. Congratulations to Boise State, they played well, beat us in really both phases, offense, defense. We never could get anything going, and that falls squarely on me. Obviously, I didn't have them ready to play. We didn't play very well. They're a good team, and you know, I thought they came out and dominated from the get-go, and we never could make up any ground. So that all go ahead and open up for questions.
Matt, it just seemed like the defense had a couple of really good series there in the first half, but the offense went 3-out on both. I mean, how hard is it to sustain any momentum when both units aren't clicking at the same time?
Yeah, I thought we played poor on defense in the first half, and I thought we were poor on offense. It was 3-out, no momentum. I got behind in the chains early in the D&D did not run the ball very well early, and you know, we weren't clicking in the passing game. We had some competitive catches that were opportunities, and we didn't make those catches. Jordan missed a couple throws. You're 3-out, and you're not able. And I thought Brett got on fire. I thought we were soft in the secondary at times and gave them too much cushion. But they played pitch and catch and took the lead. And really, we didn't make much of a dent into it.
Coach, the secondary had a couple of injuries last week against UNLV. Did that kind of play into the secondary maybe being a little bit soft in this game, maybe missing out on some practice time?
You know, we're out starters. We got a couple linebackers out and starting nickel out. I mean, but no excuse. I mean, we had We had two starting safeties and two starting corners in. We may add a new nickel, but that's no excuse to mix it up. It's game nine. We're no bye week, so yeah, I'm not going to give us that excuse.
The offense was able to move the ball better in the third quarter. Was there an adjustment that was made, or was it just kind of how the game played out?
Well, I think we made a couple of halftime adjustments, but we didn't sustain anything. I mean, we moved the ball in 8 yards, but that's just good on stats until you put the thing in the end zone. You know, it wasn't very consistent effort on offense.
Coach, you had a couple of new guys playing defensive line making their first start. Is that just a case of them moving up the depth chart, or is it because of injuries?
No, it's because the first half performance against UNLV was poor. And we started new guys, and quite frankly, Eric, when the way we rotate them, it just means they start first, they don't play more. We play them about the same right now.
How absolutely imperative is it that you avoid these slow starts three to the last four games? It's just bam, bam, they're up 14 points midway through the first quarter.
Yeah, if I knew how to, I would rather not start that way. I mean, I would rather start fast. I kind of just described the offense in the first quarter, so we've already beat that one up. Let's get another question.
You mentioned the secondary giving a little bit of protection there. Was that game plan or something Boise State was doing that allowed that to happen?
I don't think we challenged the receivers enough.
One good thing that was from the offense in this game was the lack of turnovers. No turnovers in the entire game. How much of that do you think was like the game plan? How much was Jordan Lopes being able to really kind of analyze the defense and react?
That's an interesting deal because you know you see the score lopsided. You think there was going to be a lot of turnovers. 0-0, right? And we didn't get one, I don't think. And I remember we didn't turn one over. So that gives you. I think what that does is it doesn't lose the ball game for you. Gives you a chance to win it, but I mean, 3 and outs, that number's got to be one of the higher ones we've had all year.
Anything else for Coach Rose?
Thanks, Coach.
You good?
Good.
All right.
Let's go.
Defensively, we didn't play well. We set out, you know, we had our goals and we had our game plan. Unfortunately, we didn't execute it. Me being on the back end, career high, career whatever, I guess, as a player, it really doesn't mean much. You know, at the end of the day, it's either a W or an L. And unfortunately, tonight, we were on the side of taking an L. But we need to play better as a defensive secondary. That just wasn't our night.
Cedric Wilson had a really good game for Boise State, and obviously he's a terrific player, terrific athlete. How hard is it to game plan for guys like that, and how hard is it in game when you see them having a good outing to be able to kind of recuperate as a defense and try to stop that?
It's difficult. Wilson is a great player, and you know during the week we did our best to be able to game plan and to shut him down. Give him his credit, but I still ride with our guys. Jalen Davis is a great player as well, and we felt like we had our matchups. Unfortunately, it just didn't go our way tonight. But whenever you have a great athlete on the other side of the ball to be able to cover and to take care of and shut down, it's a task. But we're a unit that takes care of tasks.
Seemed like most of those big plays, and especially in the first half, were. Boise State basically taking advantage of like a linebacker or a safety. Is that a breakdown in the defense, or is that just guys not making plays?
Honestly, in general. A lot of plays. It's hard to tell what happened exactly. But most likely, we as a secondary, we play high risk, high reward. And a lot of that would entail, man coverage. And so when you play a team that, runs good routes against man coverage, it's kind of hard. But, we should be able to do that. And, I said, some weeks we do and some weeks we don't. We just got to tighten down and get this next week ready to prepare and get back at it.
guys just, I mean, when you guys had good defensive series, the offense couldn't move the ball, and vice versa, how frustrating was it not to be clicking at the same time, both offensively and defensively?
Honestly, I thought the offense played great. As you can see, you know, being a defensive player, I don't know much about what goes on the other side of the ball. All I know is see ball, hit ball. That's what a coach tells. But, you know, we can't give them that many yards. We can't give them that many points. As a defense, you know, having that defensive mindset, we can win the game 2-0. But unfortunately, you know, we didn't do that.
It's not the first time you guys have to bounce back from a loss here at home and go out and get a win. Is there anything you guys can take away or take away from previous games to, as you go to New Mexico next week?
Of course. I was reading some quote, I think it was on Instagram or something kind of crazy like that, but it said, learning, you know, defeat is the first step in learning and progression. And, you know, obviously tonight, you know, we're heartbroken, spirits a little down, but, you know, we can analyze this film and analyze our game plan, improve technique, and, you know, it's going to be a busy week for us. We've got our work cut out for us, but, you know, this is a great opportunity to learn and progress.
I guess going along with that, how much have you kind of progressed game to game? It seems like you're getting more playing time and making more plays.
I'm trying to improve my role, if that's what you're asking.
Yeah.
You know, honestly, though, we have a – I love the guys in the room, each and every one of them. The ones that are starting out on the field and the ones that rotate in. I feel like any of us really could come in and do the job with Aaron Wade and John Troy Rockmore and Braxton Dunkley. You know, good guys, and we put in the time. But, you know, we're down a little bit on injury, however, but I feel like, you know, we got the guys. So, honestly, trying to improve.